Now, for the first example, it says calculate the principal quantum number of each atomic sublevel. Okay. It sounds complicated, but it's really easy. We're going to say that the principal quantum number is just based on the number that goes in front of the sublevel letter. So in the first one, A, 7P, the number that's in front of P is a 7. So all we would say here is that N equals 7. It's as simple as that. For B, 5S, the number in front of S is a 5, so N equals 5. For C, it would be N equals 3, and for D, it would be N equals 4. Just remember, the number that goes in front of the sublevel letter represents our principal quantum number. It's as easy as that. Now, we're going to say that the electron capacity of each shell can be determined by using the formula 2n squared, where n represents the shell number. So, if we're in the first shell, we can figure out how many electrons the first shell holds by using this formula. It would just be 2 times 1 squared. So that would just be 2. If we're in the second shell, it'd be 2 times 2 squared. So that'd be 2 times 4, which would be 8. So the second shell can hold a maximum of 8 electrons. For the third shell, it'd be 2 times 3 squared. So it'd be 2 times 9. So that would be 18. And then finally, 4, it'd be 2 times 4 squared, which is 2 times 16, which is 32. Now, we're going to say that I only went up to 4, but there's more than 4 shells, electron shells. The number of shells is based on the number of periods of the periodic table. If you guys remember, we say that groups go vertical, up and down, right? Side to side, those are our periods. On our periodic table, there are 7 periods. So that means we go up to shell number 7 when it comes to elements. And the more and more elements we discover or create in the lab, the more periods we're going to add to the periodic table. The periodic table is not static. It's always changing, ever evolving, getting bigger and bigger. So eventually it's going to come to a point where we're going to go beyond shell number 7 to shell number 8, shell number 9, who knows? It all depends how far we're willing to push to find and create new elements. Now, just remember, period number is a reflection of the electron shell number. So that was our first quantum number, principal,